I personally really love parachute pants. I would definitely want to rock those still.
Brunch. Red plaid, lots of eyeliner.
I love, like, the mink coats. Faux fur all day.
Y'all remember Dunkaroos? Dunkaroos, I love them. Those were my favorite. Too bad they don't make them anymore, but they were pretty dope.
Favorite trend from my birth.
So when I was in eighth grade, for someone I love hard drive, but physically can't really handle it. And I was with someone that I cared about very deeply, and they really wanted to go on this ride, but they didn't want to go alone. So I'm like, fine, I'll go with you. And you know, they just enjoyed it, had a blast. I got off the ride and I puked my guts out.
My friend called me at 2 a.m. and was like, "Help, I need you." So I drove 4 hours to go see her.
I once lied about liking One Direction.
Flown over 1,800 miles to give somebody a hug.
Before I went to Roxton, I took off work a week early just so I can, because he lives. Goes to school in Virginia. I took off a week early just so I could go visit him before I went to Hollis, because he couldn't come home and see me.
It was my promposal last year. I went through all of our pictures from 7th grade up until senior year. So it started off as friends, and then went from friends to best friends to relationship, and I compiled it into a video to one of, it was a French song, but it was solid.
I think rules were made to be broken.
But again, I'm also kind of a weenie.
I like to think of myself as a rule breaker, but I'm 100% a rule enforcer.
Oh, I am totally. I'm a goody two shoes. I can't. I feel so bad when I break a rule.
I'm a rule bender. I don't break all sorts of rules, but I do stretch my limits.
I don't enforce rules at all. You do what you want.
I'm a rule breaker.
Definitely. You know, I'm probably more of a rule enforcer, but when the rules are stupid, I'm more likely to break them. So, you know, I just do what, I follow my own moral compass as much as I can.
I gotta think of a good name before I move on.
No, I've always wanted to
inspect
Gadget.
Go Gadget.
Covered.
Ryan Reynolds.
Maybe Amelia Earhart and be like, hey, guess what? I'm a time traveler now. I'm back.
I think I'd want to be Rihanna, honestly.
I'm going undercover as Alexandra, which is my middle name. And Alexandra is a famous, like, international star. Like, nobody knows what she's famous for, kind of like the Kardashians, but she's famous, okay?
But Alexandra walks into a room, like,
people are like, that's me. Remember those fur coats I mentioned? That's what she wears. And that's being an international spy. Like, nobody knows.
I disguise myself as George Lopez.
Oh, okay. I go undercover as an Irish man. Charlie O'Charlie. Yeah, that's what I do.
I think I would go undercover as Jordan Rubio because I've known Jordan. We've known each other for 3 years now. And all 3 years, people confuse us for each other all the time. Inexplicably. People think we look like each other. Apparently we act like each other a lot. I don't know if it confuses us, but I want to go undercover to Jordan Rubio, see what it's like to meet him for at least a day.
Right.
10 things I hate about you.
So she's the man, but I think I'm just partial to a man of audience.
Oh, she's the man by far. That's a great movie. So I'd have to say 10 things I hate about you because I know that one. And it's a good movie and it's a pretty good adaptation.
She's the man. Definitely she's the man for one thing because 12th Night is my favorite Shakespeare. So being that it's based off of that makes
10 things I hate about you, just because I'm a huge fan of Heath Ledger and I think he's a phenomenal actor. Also, it's one of my favorite movies of all time and I think it was done very properly, so 10 things I hate about you.
I am going to say she's the man. For purely selfish personal reasons, I just like 12th Night more than I like Taming of the Shrew. And I see you for what you truly are, which is ugly!